Hi, let's talk about the inferior vena cava. In this video, we'll discuss the tributaries of the inferior vena cava. The inferior vena cava, or IVC, is a vessel that mirrors its counterpart, the abdominal aorta, in the abdominal cavity. It can be found right lateral to the abdominal aorta, and both of these vessels are retroperitoneal. Now, the inferior vena cava begins as the union of two vessels, the common iliac veins, at approximately the fifth lumbar vertebrae. And it ascends the totality of the abdomen and moves through the diaphragm at the caval opening at approximately the eighth thoracic vertebral level. There are various branches of the IVC, or tributaries, I should say, and these tributaries often are going to mirror their abdominal aorta counterparts, with the exception of there being no commensurate branches to the celiac trunk, the SMA, or the IMA, because these three vessels are going to feed the gut tube. And the gut tube is drained of blood by the hepatic portal vein. The hepatic portal vein is going to conduct blood to hepatic sinusoids, and these sinusoids are going to be drained of blood through the hepatic veins. There are typically three hepatic veins that move through the substance of the liver, and they drain into the inferior vena cava at approximately the T8 level, just inferior to the caval hiatus. Now, other branches of the inferior vena cava are going to include inferior phrenic veins that are draining the inferior portions of the diaphragm, suprarenal veins. And we notice that there is an asymmetry here. The right suprarenal vein is going to drain directly into the IVC, whereas the left suprarenal vein is going to share a common trunk with the left inferior phrenic vein, which is going to drain into the left renal vein. Both renal veins, left and right, are going to be direct tributaries into the IVC. The gonadal veins will have an asymmetry, with the right gonadal vein draining directly into the IVC, whereas the left gonadal vein is a tributary of the left renal vein. As you may recall, the relationship between the left renal vein and the superior mesenteric artery make the left renal vein particularly susceptible to compression in the case of an abdominal aortic aneurysm at about the L1 or L2 level, and that is known as left renal vein entrapment syndrome, also known as nutcracker syndrome, which would impinge on the return of blood through the left inferior phrenic vein, the left suprarenal vein, and the left gonadal vein. Finally, there are four lumbar veins. The third and the fourth pairs of lumbar veins are direct tributaries into the inferior vena cava, whereas the first and the second pairs of lumbar veins are tributaries of the azygos system. And that azygos system is going to drain into the superior vena cava. The inferior vena cava, once traversing the diaphragm at the caval opening at T8, is going to return that blood from this portion of the caval system into the right atrium. So we've discussed the location of the inferior vena cava, the tributaries of the inferior vena cava, with a specific emphasis on the asymmetry between the right and left branches. This is your summary slide. Thank you for your time.